finally.
Push it down.
I'd love to. This is that little chair of yours, isn't it?
That's not theirs.
No, that's theirs over there.
And that's mine.
It's probably that chair back there.
It's JJ's sitting on my chair, and that covers it.
Parker.
You want help with that rock?
I'm making
your request, Steven.
What?
What's that rocky request?
What?
That's me.
Well, you shouldn't have sat next to Kenny then.
I didn't. He sat next to me.
You hold my Bible.
Oh. You weren't preaching.
Oh, yeah.
Again!
Than we were when I first got up this morning. I think we'd kind of have to be. We're looking a little weary this morning. How many of you were looking weary?
Yes.
Yep.
How many of you are really looking forward to a nap?
And a shower.
And how many of you are really looking forward to a shower?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
And how many of you are really looking forward to the rest of your household having a shower? We can be honest here. One of the things I love about coming to a campout is the opportunity we have to just come as we are, because there's really not a whole lot of other options when we're sharing two seats between us, no showers, and cold water.
Mm-hmm.
And that's okay. I don't want to live my whole life without a shower, but for a weekend, it's great to come away. And to put off some of the, truly unnecessary. And it's taken some time. It's taken a lot of energy to get up here and to bring all of our stuff. And we're moving out of our houses and living in the mountains for a couple of days. It's good to be here together. And it's good to go back and shower. Psalm 66. Shout with joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing praise to your name. Come and see what God has done. How awesome his works on man's behalf. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the waters on foot. Come, let us rejoice in him. He rules forever by his power. His eyes watch the nations. Let not the rebellious rise up against him. Praise our God, O peoples. Let the sound of his praise be heard. He has preserved our lives and kept our feet from slipping. For you, O God, tested us. You refined us like silver. You brought us into prison and laid burdens on our backs. You let men ride over our heads. We went through fire and water. But you brought us to a place of abundance. I will come to your temple with burnt offerings and fulfill my vows to you. Vows my lips promised and my mouth spoke when I was in trouble. I will sacrifice fat animals to you, and an offering of rams I will offer bulls and goats. Come and listen, all you who fear God. Let me tell you what he has done for me. I cried out to him with my mouth. His praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But God has surely listened and heard my voice in prayer. Praise be to God who has not rejected my prayer or withheld his love from me. We're going to have opportunity today to worship through song, through prayer, and testimony, and scripture, and then we'll head down the mountain, and we'll go back into what we call ordinary life, and the weekend, as it exists, will be over. But there will be, as the Psalms so often remind us, there are memories. There are memories of what God has done among us, in friendships, in laughter, in discipline, in all of those things. And we take with us those memories, just as we take with us the memories of what God has done in the past. So let's pray, and then we'll sing. Father God, I thank you for these beautiful mountains, and we truly are blessed to have them so close, to be able to drive a little bit and be in the midst of this beauty, to be in a place where it truly is an effort to have flush toilets. And I thank you, God, for providing this for us, for providing this time away, for providing these friendships, for all the things that you have done. Thank you, God, for watering the ground yesterday and making it dry as we pack up today. For the food, for the rest, for the fun. As we worship you today, God, reorient our hearts and our minds to you so that we will see you more clearly. I pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
You were saved, I deserved it. You were good.
Not the wild horse.
My soul, Jesus, I'm
reading from Mark 2, beginning with verse 23. One Sabbath, Jesus was going through the grain fields, and as his disciples walked along, they began to pick some heads of grain. The Pharisees said to them, "Look, why are they doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" He answered, "Have you never read what David did when he and his companions were hungry and in need? In the days of Abiathar the high priest, he entered the house of God and ate the consecrated bread, which is lawful only for the priest to eat. And he also gave some to his companions. Then he said to them, 'The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath.' Another time he went into the synagogue, and a man with a shriveled hand was there. Some of them were looking for a reason to accuse Jesus, so they watched him closely to see if he would heal him on the Sabbath. Jesus said to the man with the shriveled hand, 'Stand up in front of everyone.' Then Jesus asked them, 'Which is lawful on the Sabbath, to do good or do evil, to save life or to kill?' But they remained silent. He looked around at them in anger and deeply distressed at their stubborn hearts, said to the man, 'Stretch out your hand.' He stretched it out, and his hand was completely restored. Then the Pharisees went out and began to plot with the Herodians how they might kill Jesus." I was always confused by verse 6, especially as a kid. Then the Pharisees went out and began to plot with the Herodians how they might kill Jesus. I never understood that. That did not make sense. Because Jesus is there saying they were hungry, and God made it okay for them to have something to eat. And there was a man who needed healing, and God healed them. And therefore they plotted to kill him? That didn't make sense to me. Then again, I remember going to church on Sunday mornings. This is one of those back when I was a kid stories. Now, kids, you might have noticed that sometimes it's hard to sit still, right? I'm 37. Sometimes it's still hard to sit still. But the nice thing is that we have, at church, cushy chairs. Here, we have some cushy chairs, some park benches, some rocks. We make do. But I remember being about 6 years old, sitting on benches with wood slats, so every time I moved, you know what they did? Good impression. Well done. Yeah, you know what my mom did? I don't see any good mom impressions here. See, you're a pretty good mom impression. Mr. Martinez has a good mom impression. I didn't realize that the Sabbath is made for me. I was not made just for the rules of the Sabbath. Now, kids, I was talking to you, and I'll talk to you again. Hi, Freud. I'm glad you're here. Why do we have church? Any ideas?
To celebrate.
To celebrate what, Parker?
Jesus' resurrection.
Yeah? Yeah, we do that. Didn't we do that last week, though?
Yeah.
Why do we do it again this week?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, that's I do agree that we're here to celebrate. Why do we do it again? Yeah? So we can keep learning, huh? Yeah. You know what I have found out? Sometimes we forget. Sometimes we forget all sorts of stuff. I forget my own birthday. I definitely need to come back to church and celebrate again. Because sometimes I forget even really important stuff. And that's why I read from Psalm 66 at the very beginning today. Because Psalm 66, that's a psalm that's been used in worship for a long, long time. And it tells very, very briefly some really important stories of God. Just like Parker said, we come together to tell again and again and again very important stories of God. we have a whole book here of very important stories of God. And I'm going to ask you in a few minutes if you have a story of God, something that sometimes you forget, or something that you forget about God. And then we can remember together. But first, a little bit about Sabbath, some things that I have been learning about Sabbath since I sat in those very creaky, uncomfortable wood slatted pews. Sabbath is made for man. We need Sabbath. That just doesn't mean church, that means Sabbath. Sabbath is an opportunity for us to rest. What do you do when you rest?
Go to sleep.
Sleep is a wonderful part of it. What else?
You have a better attitude.
Oh, better attitude. We're going to come back to that, yeah? We have what?
Dreams.
Sometimes we have dreams. That's when you're sleeping real good.
Our muscles recover.
Yeah. I used to take naps poorly. And Mark, was it actually your mom or mine? I should remember this. You don't have to sleep, but you do have to rest. We were not necessarily required to nap as long as, for all intents and purposes, it looked to her like we were napping. You're not required to sleep as long as you are sitting still. Napping usually happens next, but it doesn't have to. We are restored. Our muscles are restored. Our minds are restored. Our attitudes, like Parker said, are restored. And I'd say that fits with this reorientation. Matthew, Mark, and Luke all tell this story of Sabbath. Matthew, from chapter 12. If any of you has a sheep and it falls into a pit, will you not take hold of it and lift it out? How much more valuable is man than a sheep? And it seems that they had gotten a little off track on their worship, on what Sunday was about, on what God was about. And an important part of this Sabbath was helping them to become more like Jesus, to reorient their thoughts, their understanding, like the teaching you brought up, their attitudes. Sabbath is a time to reorient. And it is a time to worship. Kenny brought his guitar with us. We missed you last year, Kenny, by the way. I think I told you that last year, but in case I didn't, there you go. And it's good to worship again. I was confused also as a child. Why did we sing all of these songs? It was more confusing as a child because we sang songs with words I did not know. Some of them sounded weird. I did not know until later. I did not realize until later that we sing those songs as another way of reorienting to God, to remembering who God is. And so as we do that together, we could have gotten all sorts of individual campsites this year. We could have all gone off into the mountains all by ourselves. But we chose to come together, and we chose to worship together. And so together, I will ask you, what words would you use to describe God today that are particularly meaningful to you? What parts of God's nature have you seen at work in your life?
Constant.
Thank you. What else?
Amazing.
Friend.
Disciplinary prison. Disciplinary prison.
Disciplinary. A god of order, not of disorder.
A mystery.
A mystery. Whenever I'm out in nature, I think of God's power and sovereignty. I see so much that is unpredictable about God. And I remember how much I am not in control. And that, I'd say, is an important part of why I go camping. Because it reminds me who I am and who God is. And who I am not. Because sometimes we need those reminders too. So, as we go from here, I encourage you to go with rest and restoration. The general sense I have around here, we might need a nap. And some laundry and some showers. And a nap. The rest I hope for this weekend is not just sleep, although sleep's a part of it. The rest I hope for is a restoring of our souls, becoming again who we are created to be, becoming more who we are created to be. And so, let's pray, and we will sing, and we will dismiss. Father God, I thank you for bringing us together, for the ways that you work in our hearts and minds, even when we're not paying attention, sometimes especially when we don't know what's going on. We come today, we come yesterday, we come on Friday with things on our minds, things on our plates, whatever it is that seems to wait for us. And it is good, God, to be able to put that aside for a while and to focus on you and to return to it with greater knowledge of you at our side. For those who are ill, who are in the midst of uncertainty, for those who are in times of waiting, for those who grieve, I pray for an abundant, abundant sense of your presence, that we will know you more, and that we will trust you better. In the name of Christ, amen.
Thank you. Dissolve like snow. The sun will